Harris, Red Rum, 3-2. Height 6 feet, weight 155 pounds. Fighting out of Dan Henderson's Athletic Fitness and Team Quest in Temecula, California. Chris Saunders in the red corner from Montreal, Quebec, Canada, now living in SoCal for many years. 12-7 overall, a Bellator and UFC veteran. 5'8", 156 pounds, out of the sweatshop and Bloody Brothers Muay Thai. Title eliminator bout, the winner gets a shot at the title.
Interesting, that title picture now, though.
Oh, yeah.
Well, that was a potential title challenger performance right there. We definitely have a title challenger performance coming up between Chris Saunders and Brandon Morris. The winner will fight for the 155-pound belt.
All right, ladies and gentlemen, it's main event time. Introducing first to the cage, Brandon Morris.
Brandon Morris, they call him Red Rum. 3-2 as a professional. He trains at Team Quest with the likes of Dan Henderson. He said the first time he went to go train at Team Quest, he was so nervous, he drove around the gym twice before he parked to go in because he couldn't bring himself, give himself the nerves to head in there, but I'm sure he's glad he braved it and entered that fantastic training facility.
Well, that's how I feel when I go to 24-hour fitness.
So that's how I feel when I go to the doctor.
I can relate, and the dentist. But that's a great gym, you know, to cut your teeth at, that's for sure. How about Sam Alvey, Team Quest?
Right.
Did some work at MFC, and man, he's been lighting people up in the UFC. And see, going back to what I was saying, that's a guy that when he wins, he tells you what he wants next. He starts calling specific names. He's been getting them. Hey, by the way, great interview, post-fight interview there with Christian Aguilera.
He wanted I liked to do the something, very he did it.
He said, I want the title. Come get me. Come yep. at me. And the crowd went nuts.
You got to set that foundation, man, for your next fight. But like I was telling George, that's no reward to have to face that guy.
Yeah. I think we're seeing something special, Christian Aguilera. I really do.
A special night altogether.
And ladies and gentlemen, his opponent, Chris Saunders.
Here he is, Chris Saunders, born in Canada, now lives down here in Southern California. UFC veteran, Bellator veteran. You saw him at Bad Beat 15 just a few months ago, win by first round guillotine choke. He's really added a nice submission to his arsenal. We'll see what he chooses to use tonight against Brandon Morris.
Somebody in this corner has an epic beard. Who's that guy? I'm surprised the mouthpiece isn't in his beard.
Somebody has to do that at some point, pull a mouthpiece out of their beard.
It's probably really hard to knock out a beard like that.
Huh?
Hey, how about a shout out to J.R. Calderon, the matchmaker here for Bama USA for their Bad Beat series. I mean, you know, we're looking at pretty even records across the board. The fights have delivered. Mm-hmm. And Brett Roberts, the promoter, was telling me, you know, slowly but surely, JR got groomed into that role. He's had a great night tonight.
Definitely.
Really, really even matchmaking. Shout out to JR.
And if you think the UFC matchmakers have it tough with fighters dropping out,
yeah.
injuries, try doing it on the local scene when it's not guys, you know, with 15, 20 fights, but people still coming up sometimes with one, two, three fights. Trying to organize 26 fighters to be here at this time, make weight at that time, fill out that paperwork, make sure the commissioner sees that. That'll gray your hairs real quick, and he pulled it off tonight.
Most of them still holding
night.
Full-time jobs.
Yep.
It's a tough sport, guys.
I heard some of the fighters that are 0-0 are sometimes a little harder to work with than some of the veterans that we've been talking about all night.
Yep. It's part of being a young fighter should know. Part of being a professional fighter is not just being good at fighting, not even just making yourself noticed with the mic in your face, but just being a professional, being good to work with, being on time. Just, you know, simple, basic things that you'd think people would know, but, you know, fighters are a rare breed. That's why they're in the cage fighting.
little excess grease up there on Saunders' noggin. They were wiping it down. Oil, grease, I don't know.
Hair product.
Ladies and gentlemen, damas y caballeros, once again, we welcome you to the largest poker casino in the world, the Commerce Casino. We are now set for the Bad Beat 16 main event of the evening. It is a Bama USA lightweight title eliminator. The winner will go on to challenge for the undisputed Bama USA lightweight championship. Presented by Bama USA and sponsored by the undisputed king of beers, Budweiser. Sanctioned by the California State Athletic Commission. Commission Chairman John Carvelli, Executive Officer Andy Foster. The three judges scoring your main event on a 10-point must system, Chris Crail, Jackie Denkin, and Gene LaBelle. And the third man in the cage, our referee in charge of the action, Mike Bell. And now, ladies and gentlemen, the temperature is rising, the lights are bright, and the main event is here, live from the Commerce Casino. Fight fans of Commerce, California, everybody go local! Introducing first, ladies and gentlemen, the man standing to my right and fighting out of the blue corner. Standing in even 6 feet tall, official weight 155.8 pounds. He is a freestyle fighter with a pro record of 3 victories, opposite 2 defeats. Representing Dan Henderson's Athletic Fitness Center and Team Quest, fighting out of Temecula, California, here is Brandon Red Rock. And across the cage, his opponent fighting out of the red corner. Standing 5 feet, 8 inches tall, official weight 156 pounds. Raised in the fighting disciplines of Muay Thai and kickboxing, he holds a pro record of 12 victories, opposite 7 defeats. Representing Sweatshop Gym and Blood Brothers Muay Thai, fighting out of Long Beach, California, by way of Montreal, Quebec, Canada, here is Chris Saunders. Once again, our referee in charge, Mike Bell, to give the instructions.
All right, gentlemen, you've got instructions backstage. Defend up at all times, obey my commands at all times. If you want to touch gloves, do it now. Back to court.
Main event, this is what we came here for. Lightweight championship title shot is on the line with Chris Saunders and Brandon Morris, scheduled for 3 5-minute rounds. Mike Bell, your referee, and here we go. RJ Clifford, Gorgeous George in the goes. On the call tonight, Chris Saunders in the shorter white shorts, Brandon Morris in the longer red shorts.
I feel like we've watched 12 main events tonight already.
We kind of have.
This is just gravy, honestly.
Bonus fights.
This is like me walking out of here and just finding like $100 bill outside or something. But here we go, the main event. Saunders and Morris. Morris, big right hand there. Saunders caught it with his forearms.
Morris doing a good job of just getting out of trouble on all those strikes. Saunders gonna have to push forward a little bit more.
Still trying to find his range. Definitely had a reach disadvantage, Chris Saunders. Combination lands by Saunders. Uppercut
nice
lands
up
by Saunders. Morris responds. And a flurry from Saunders.
Crowd goes nuts. Nice uppercut there in the clinch. Morris shakes it off, puts him up against the cage. Morris disengages, misses with an uppercut. And now he's back in stalker mode.
Singling attempts and right into the guillotine.
Oh, that's pretty tight.
This is Chris Saunders' new signature move. This is how
tight.
He finished his last fight. He This would be his third guillotine in four fights if he can pull this off. It looks like it's under the chin, and that looks tight.
That looks tight.
He's in trouble there, guys.
Does Morris have some sort of a breathing tube down there, or what? Wow.
Whatever it was, it got him out of there. He's able to survive. What guts out of Brandon Morris.
That's gotta
now
take
he's
a little
got a
bit
darts.
Of starch out of, more, out of Saunders.
Now Morris attacks with a choke of his own. He rolls it to the ground. Tit for tat, choke for choke, and now he's on top. Can he turn the tide? Chris Saunders fighting the hands, and he's out.
He's out.
What an opening sequence from both fighters.
And how do you score this round? It's right down the middle, man.
For me, the fight just restarted right now.
It sure did.
Less hook into a head kick. Beautiful technique by Chris Saunders. Deep double leg. And another guillotine attempt by Saunders. Oh, he bails on it. Didn't feel like he had it.
Oh,
but
nice
he relocked
slam.
It up. Morris able to get to the side and back out of trouble. Now on the side mount. Saunders up and exposes his neck again.
How about the pace of round one, guys? Non-stop action here.
Jab by Saunders in the 1-2. Leg kick. Ball.
Nice combination.
Followed up by a jab and another leg kick by Morris.
Deep body lock by Morris, and he turns into another takedown.
That's probably been the difference, guys. It's been pretty even, but Morris got a couple nice takedowns.
Saunders, I think, still having trouble judging that distance in the stand-up.
And another darts attempt. Saunders able to shrug it off this time.
Saunders just grinned it off, but I think it hurt him. Or at least got his attention.
Uh-oh. Got him to respond. He's responding with knees from the clinch.
So we got the 10-second count there.
Nice short elbow by Saunders.
Wow.
Fantastic. Great first round in the main event.
Oh, man. Great first round.
I think the ring card girl was shocked that there was a round two.
Look at that uppercut.
Let's take a look at some of the early action. Very aggressive Chris Saunders early.
Morris was right there, man, throwing his own. This guillotine was really, really tight right here. Saunders squeezing.
Lesser fighters would have tapped out already
right
at this point. Brandon Morris able to fight out of it.
Now Morris goes for his own choke. Great knees there by Saunders in the clinch.
Beautiful aggression out of Chris Saunders. You can almost see a sneer in his face when he's lining up combos.
I think Saunders just outstruck him a little bit. They both had submission attempts. Morris had two takedowns. That round could honestly go either way, man. Judges got the work cut off for themselves.
Highly competitive, highly entertaining, possibly controversial as we move into the second frame. High body lock by Brandon Morris as the taller fighter, that's a great advantage.
Good trip by Saunders.
See what Saunders can do up top.
Tenderizing the ribs a little bit. Delivers a short elbow. And now he takes the back of the
his hands and arms, but
he's disengaged.
Hooks it briefly.
Best punch of the fight.
Brandon Morris doing a great job of punching into a double leg, but he just pushed himself into a guillotine.
He's going to tap.
What a finish!
That's the fight. It's all over. Nice guillotine submission by Chris Saunders. Morris basically slammed or picked him up and fell into that.
Yeah, the crowd's going nuts over here.
What a fantastic turn of events. And a reversal by Chris Saunders. He turned a deep double leg, which should have been a slam with his head bouncing off the canvas, turned it into a one-arm showstopper.
That's the experience right there, you guys.
Here we go with the replay.
That's
Morris picks him up.
That's a deep double leg, hands underneath the butt. And what hip positioning and awareness by Saunders.
Look at Saunders had to regain that.
One-arm guillotine.
Amazing.
And he earned himself a Bama USA title shot.
And that was the theme of the night, guys. Great submissions tonight, honestly. Great fights, great finishes, but a lot of them via submission.
Reversals, back and forth. One guy on top, one guy switched.
Boy, it's too bad we got to wait till October for the next one.
Flipping that calendar quickly.
Here we go again with another angle. Morris comfortable, putting him down for the third time of the night, except it gets flipped over. Saunders with one arm is able to get underneath that neck and get the tap.
Chris Saunders' last three wins, all by guillotine choke. He's been in the game a while, but you can still see he's still evolving, still finding new tricks, still sharpening the tools that he already has.
I'm down with Morris, though, Brandon Morris. I want to see him fight again, too.
Good performance. You know, if October 2nd rolls around and we see a few rematches from tonight, I wouldn't have any problems with that.
Not one bit. Loud contingent here for Chris Saunders. All right, we're going to send it up to Jeff Houston for the official announcement.
Ladies and gentlemen, the end of the main event comes at 1 minute 28 seconds, round number 2, for the winner by tap out from a guillotine choke and the new number 1 contender for the undisputed Bama USA Lightweight Championship from Long Beach, California, Chris Saunders.
All right, Chris, what a fight, what a performance. Back and forth, you both exchanged strikes, you both got out of submissions. How do you feel about your performance tonight?
I feel phenomenal about my performance. I have to thank Brandon Morris. This guy pushed me to a point I didn't know I could go, and I'm thankful that he did.
Walk us through that final submission, because he had you up in the air, it looked like you were gonna get slammed, but you turned it into a one-arm guillotine.
Yeah, I practice this guillotine a lot. I have to thank Uriah Faber, being on the show and things like that, on Tough. I got really good, and actually, if you saw it, it was a one-arm guillotine, you know, so it was very hard to do, but I managed to pull it off.
How's it feel being the number one contender for Bama USA?
It's a great honor and privilege. I tried to get on Bama USA card a long time ago, and, you know, I'm happy that finally happened. Alhamdulillah.
You've got a lot of fans cheering behind you. What can all your fans expect when you fight for the Bama USA title? What can fans expect?
Another great performance from me, coming with a level head. And I'm going to do my thing. Oos, Moroccan magic, Dutch style kickboxing. Oos, we in the house.
Put your hands together for another great performance out of Chris Saunders.
where in the world do we start, Ghost? Tonight's fights have been insane.
Here's the